in the media.
Technically, it's mine.
It's not true. She left it to both of us.
You haven't touched this in your life.
No, I... Remember the time at Aunt Linda's house in September of 2019 when you kept swinging the camera around because Mom told you how strong the straps were and you hit me in the face?
That doesn't count.
Really, my black eye had a different opinion.
Got you out of the first week of school.
Do you know how hard it is to adjust a bunch of autistic boys to a new routine after they already learned one?
I've never gone to the same school before.
Well... they just talk about me behind my back, especially the teachers. Like, Jack, why can't you be more normal? Jack, why are you so snippy? Jack, can't you have a normal autistic hobby like trains? I don't know Melinda, probably because I'm not an autistic boy.
Hey, if anyone says anything bad about you, I'll... right across the face.
Can we go over the morning routine one more time?
Oh. I thought, you know, now that Mom's gone and Dad's always working, we could just ditch the whole morning routine.
Sam, I'm autistic. It's routine or die.
Hi, autistic. I'm Chaos. Nice to meet you. Fine. Jack, do you have your wallet?
Yes.
If you're going to make me do this, don't just say yes. Actually look.
No.
Snacks? Headphones? Tablet? Shoes? How did you forget shoes?
I don't like the feeling of the socks between my toes.
Okay. Am I forgetting anything?
Did you take your ADHD medication? How did you forget your ADHD medication?
I have ADHD. Want some?
No, thanks.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't like the texture of the peanut butter.
But you love peanut butter.
Yeah, I love peanut butter, but I don't like the texture of the peanut butter in the bar. It gets stuck to the roof of my mouth, and then I have to spend the next hour and 45 minutes picking at it with the tip of my tongue, because if I put my fingers on my mouth, I just hear Mom go, take your fingers out of your mouth, it's disgusting.
No, you gotta do it with the accent. Get your fingers out of your mouth, it's disgusting. Change your mind.
How would I change my mind?
What?
Like, would a scientist come and cut my brain out of my body and put it in somebody else's?
Jack, it's just an expression.
Well, then who would be the real Jack? Like, if a neurotypical's brain is in my body, would I still be autistic?
I wish I could switch minds with somebody right now. You okay?
Yeah,
I'm just picking at this peanut butter bar, thinking about all the ways today can go wrong for fun. Like, I could be late for class, or I could cough, and then everyone will think I have COVID, and then no one will talk to me, and they'll make fun of me for the rest of the year. It's fun.
Okay. Were you being sarcastic?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, why are you nervous? You've been to a normal school before.
I wouldn't exactly describe my old school as normal.
Well, you've been around non-sped kids, though.
Don't say sped.
Why? We're special ed.
Yes, but... don't.
Well, that's what Melinda used to call us in our old school.
Jack, when someone calls you that, you're not being nice.
So, what's the rule for school?
What?
Well, Mom always said when I enter a new social situation, there are rules so I don't make a fool of myself.
Yeah, I always hated it when she said that.
So, what's the rule?
I don't know. Maybe... don't be a snitch.
What's snitch mean?
A snitch is someone who tells the truth, causing for someone else to get in trouble.
But Dad says I'm always supposed to tell the truth.
You are, but let's say one of our friends breaks the rules. You just keep it to yourself and no one gets in trouble.
Keep it to yourself.
Okay. Ready?
Yeah.
You wanna go first?
I think you should go first.
Together.
On break? Ready?
One, two, three. Do you know where to find your next class?
Yeah. Me and Dad practiced navigating school last weekend.
Okay.
Do you need help?
No, I got it. I'll see you at lunch.
Okay.
I don't know where it is, but I could walk with you.
Samantha.
I go by Sam.
Ashley. I was waiting for you in the front. Dr. Lampert assigned me to be your West Side ambassador.
Dr. Lampert?
The principal. She figured you could use a tour.
Oh. Sorry I'm late. My sister's autistic.
Oh, and... that's so sad. I totally get it. I'm actually the president of the school's Autism Alliance.
That's awesome.
Thanks. I should probably get going.
Wait. Could you walk with me to my next class?
Sure. Where is it?
It's,
Room 113.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I can.
Oh.
I can walk with you to the staircase, though.
Oh, thanks.
Can I see your phone?
Sure.
Wow. Your phone's so barren.
Thanks.
It's like you came here from another planet. I'm just kidding.
It's actually new, so...
Was your own phone attached to a wall or something?
Only when I plugged it in.
Well, text me if you have any more questions.
Thanks. I will.
And just go down the hallway and room 113 should be on the right side. Or is it the left? Whatever. It'll be on the side of the hallway.
Okay. Thank you.
You're so welcome. And now if you excuse me, I have a very important free period to get into.
Okay.
You have fifth period lunch, right?
Yes.
We should do lunch.
Sounds good, but I promised my sister I would sit with her.
Bring her.
Are you sure?
Yeah. It'll be fun.
Okay. See you then.
Practicing my facial expressions so I know what they look like.
Why?
My facial expressions don't always match up to my emotions, and it makes people upset.
Okay. So, are you an actor, or are you just sped?
My sister says you're not supposed to say that.
Relax, it's just a question. It's not like I'm asking you if you're retarded.
Retard isn't a medical term.
Well, my dad's been a sped teacher for 24 years. So, I think he knows what he's talking about. That's the second bell. You better get moving if you want to get a class on time.
It's okay. My headphones are dead, so they're in my bag. I forgot to charge them last night. I'll just wait for the hallways to clear out so it's quieter, and then I'll go recharge them in resource room.
Okay. Just sped. Got it.
I'm gonna tell my sister about what she said to me.
Oh, I'm so scared.
Hi. I'm Sam. What's your name?
That's Paris. He doesn't talk, like, ever.
Oh, hey Sam.
This is Katie. I met her in APUSH.
Actually, my pronouns are they, them.
They, them. Sorry. Got it. You're taking APUSH?
Yeah. I thought it was a class about pushing buttons for a while, but then I figured out it wasn't.
Hmm. Are you sure about APUSH?
Yeah, why?
You thought it was a class about pushing buttons.
Okay, I figured it out eventually.
Jack actually is the reason we won Founding Fathers Jeopardy.
I'm not surprised. She's obsessed with Hamilton.
I'm not obsessed.
You screen recorded it and put it on VHS.
Okay, I like physical media.
And I like not being sued by Lin-Manuel Miranda for illegally downloading Hamilton and putting it on a VHS.
You know, that should be your new fun fact.
Oh, fifth period, my new friend invited me to lunch.
What about me?
You can come too.
Can Katie come?
Sure, whatever. Where's the teacher?
Oh, Miss Hooker is head of the special ed department, so she's like never here.
We're in a special ed class?
No.
Yes. Yeah.
No.
We had resource room in my old school.
It doesn't mean it's a special ed class.
Well, it was a school for kids with special needs.
So what?
Resource room is like a guided study hall led by a certified special education teacher to help guide you and help you advocate for yourself within the classroom. It's normally helpful, but Miss Hooker is too busy hookering up with her new GF.
Ew. I didn't write it.
Yeah, but you said it.
So? It's not my words.
It did come out of your mouth, though.
So?
So, with great power comes great responsibility.
Uncle Ben.
Although, Stanley wrote it, and we don't associate it with him.
Fact check. In the comics, it was a narrator, not Uncle Ben.
Yeah, but Uncle Ben said it in the movies, and that's what we associate it with.
So, this is my legacy now.
Yep.
Hey, Sam. Can I talk to you?
What's up?
Can I, talk to you privately?
Wait till after lunch.
After lunch.
Okay.
Sam! You
have to stop being late to everything. It's so selfish.
Sam really doesn't like physical touch.
Ashley, meet my sister.
Oh, hi. It's so nice to officially meet you, Jack. Please, have a seat.
This is Katie.
Oh, so you're all new?
Ashley, I've known you since the first grade.
Not possible. I'd never forget a face.
You sure about that?
Yeah. I've never lost a game of Guess Who.
You once asked Mr. Weinberg if he was a Jew because he had the snout of a greyhound.
Well, I couldn't say German Shepherd. Sorry, that was dumb. I'm trying to actively unlearn the beliefs of my parents. I swear. Plus, it's not like anyone here is Jewish, so no harm.
Actually,
no harm.
Right. Anyway.
Jack, Ashley was just telling me that she's the president of the Westside Autism Alliance.
It's true. You and Jack should totally stop by. We're having a meeting today after school. I'm sure people would love to meet Jack.
Yeah, see? Love to meet you.
Sam, I know we're outdoors, but let's use our indoor voices, okay? Why don't you bring Jack and her friends at 3:15 to room 132?
You guys know I'm not deaf. I can speak for myself, right?
Wow. You're so brave. Shoot, I'm gonna be late. Sorry, my ADHD is acting up.
Oh, you have ADHD?
You're hilarious, Jack.
Did I miss a joke?
So, Paris just doesn't talk?
Yeah, pretty much. It's been like that since middle school.
Why?
I don't know. Just kind of stopped talking.
So, does he like ever raise his hand in class?
Not really, and the teachers have stopped calling on him because he just won't talk.
I'm not going to the AA meeting.
Why would you?
You're not an alcoholic.
No, I mean the Autism Alliance.
What? Why not?
Because Ashley isn't being nice to you.
I just think that you're terrible at reading social situations.
Exactly. Even a little old autistic me could see it as a problem. That's debatable.
Well, I'm taller.
No, you're not. Katie, who's taller?
Me. I'm taller than both of you.
Okay, Sam, stop getting off topic.
You brought Katie into this.
Yeah, whatever, you need to stick up for yourself.
Jack, as you enter the real world, you're gonna learn that people suck. For every bigot you fight, you're just gonna find another.
Sam, my whole life I've gone to a school where the teachers treated me as if I was five. They'd make choices for me, even if I was in the room. I was taught that instead of removing myself from an uncomfortable situation, I had to learn to live with it. That if I didn't stop crying, I'd be punished. No saltine for me. But if I did stop crying, guess what? I got a 16th of a cracker. Not a full one, a 16th. Only one person in my whole life has treated me equal, and that's you. You don't treat me different because I'm autistic. You treat me different because I'm your twin sister.
You don't look autistic.
It's offensive.
I'll deal with that later, okay? Listen, I've looked up to you my whole life. Don't let Ashley make you something you're not.
Jack, you're gonna have to trust me, okay?
I don't
trust me.
Welcome to Westside Autism Alliance. I'm so happy that you guys are able to join my club. I feel so passionate about it. Just, are you on your phones? Let me, like, get off. We're trying to do something really important right now. We're trying to find a cure for autism. It's so sad. I feel so badly for people with autism. Like, their lives, it's just so much harder and...
I don't know.
Sam, Jack, and, it's great to see you.
I have a name. It's Katie.
Sorry, Sadie. Jack, I wanted to apologize about what happened earlier in the bathroom.
What happened in the bathroom?
Nothing important.
Jack?
We don't snitch on our friends.
So, is everyone here?
Yeah, you're looking at them.
Is everyone here autistic?
Actually, my dad says it's now people with autism, and I think it's just Jack.
I'm autistic, not a person with autism, and I never told you I was autistic.
Sam did. She said that your autism was acting up, and that's why you were late.
You did?
Well, I didn't use those words exactly.
You know that's not how that works, right?
Yeah, I know.
Why did you say it?
I don't know.
Yeah, you do.
No, I don't.
What, am I just some failure for you to constantly help?
No.
Then what?
Unlike you, Mom and Dad didn't pay attention to me growing up. It wasn't until I was 10, until I was told that my brain works differently. Maybe because when I'm late or I couldn't think, it was easier to tell people I had a disabled sister.
So I'm just your excuse to get out of trouble?
No. You're my excuse to skip the line at Six Flags.
I can't believe that.
I thought you were proud of being autistic.
I am.
Then why are you so angry that I told Ashley you were
angry you told Ashley I'm autistic because my whole life I've grown up in special school. And this was my one chance to be normal. But no, you took that from me. Just because I'm proud of my disability does not mean I'm comfortable with it. And out of anyone here, you should understand that.
Jack, wait.
This is a safe space, Jack.
No, it is not. No, it's not.
We're just trying to do what's best for you.
No, look at that. You're telling me I don't have the right to exist. I'm not some puzzle piece that you need to put in a puzzle and fix. You know, I have a question for anybody here. Anybody here. Do I look sick? Am I sick? Am I sick? Do I look sick?
Well, you're just probably not like my brother, who's very low functioning. You're more like the good doctor.
So I'm a stereotype. I'm a stereotype, right? But I mean, I guess it's okay for you to be, and thousands of organizations across the country to be advocating for what's right for me without ever talking to me?
Well, there's a lot of people with autism who can't speak up for themselves.
Then listen to the ones who can. Sam, how are you okay with this? How is anyone okay with this? You know what, Sam, how would you feel if I created a club for ADHD to cure ADHD?
They already do that. It's called Adderall or Vyvanse.
Medication isn't a cure. It helps, but it's not a cure.
So why do I need one?
I was gonna walk home, but I kind of forgot my keys at the house. We should really add that to the morning routine.
You know I don't think you need to be cured, right?
I mean, I've never actually heard you say it, so.
Jack? You don't need to be cured.
I don't think you need to be cured either.
Sam,
why are we always hiding?
I don't think we're hiding.
We're disabled and Jewish. When are we not hiding?
Do you remember what Mom and Dad said to us when we were first adopted?
Stop playing with Sam's hair?
Yes. But they also said, the world is filled with people who are going to tell you what you can't do. It's your job to show them what you can.
You know, I think they stole that from something.
Well, they said it, so we associate it with them.
So that's their legacy?
Yep.
Sam, why did you never tell me you felt neglected?
I don't know. It's not something people really talk about.
No, but how did you expect me to know if you didn't tell me? I can't read your body language.
I don't. All my life, I've dealt with my problems on my own.
But you're not alone.
I know. Neither are you.
Can I give you a hug?
No. I don't like physical touch.
I know, that's why I asked. Can we get going?
Yeah, about that.
What?
I left my keys at home.
Sam!
You wanna go get ice cream?
Only if you're paying.
Anything you want, adventures to convos. I'll be your confidant, let's watch all the kids shows, yeah. Show me your weird and your nerdy sides, and I'll show you mine. When things get crazy, all is
the reason when you asked me, like when you said that I don't look autistic, the reason Sam said it was offensive was because autism doesn't have a look, you know? Like there's no look to autism. It's not something you can see, and so, yeah. I mean, you didn't mean anything offensive when you said it, but sometimes people say that, like, offensively, and so. Mm-hmm. The only type of look that there is the stereotype, and that's not even real, because it's a stereotype.
How do you ask someone if they're autistic, or no?
I mean, I'd say never assume somebody's autistic. And normally it's an established trust between people. Like, normally an autistic person will tell a person once they trust them enough. Or even normally the person will tell somebody. It's not like, if you have to ask, then I feel like they wouldn't want to know. They wouldn't want to tell you. You know what I mean? And I mean, never assume, I feel like, because you never know.
Why is it termed autistic, not person with autism now? What's the difference?
Because like when you say person with autism, I mean, I feel like the best way to explain it is like, it's not something I have, it's a part of me. So it's not something that needs to be cured, or it's like not something separate from me, like the strep, like strep throat would be.
Mm-hmm.
It's part of me, you know?
Is that why the puzzle piece is considered like offensive or not right now? Because it's not something that you need to fix or put into place.
Yeah, and also, I mean, it's associated with people we don't really associate with that don't treat us right, you know?
Okay.